We're back with the XR Pro Mongoose. Now I'm going to show you guys what I've done here after I put the one by on. Of course, you have to have a chain stay, chain guide. Who wants to pay for it? So I'm going to show you how to make this out of this. This is what you'll need to complete this little task. Shrink wrap, you'll need two of those, screwdriver, drill, two zip ties, a lighter, snips, the reverse reflector because of the angle. You can't use the front, it's just a totally different setup, but this works perfect, and a screwdriver. First thing you're going to need to do is separate the reflector from the mount. You need a flathead screwdriver. And you just place right under this latch here, prop it forward, and push it. See how it came out? Pretty simple. You just separate the two. Always keep this stuff here, you know you're going to need stuff for. And there you go. After you have slid the reflector off of the housing, you will take your shrink wrap tube and place it over the smallest end. And I use a little bit of soap and water to make this just go on a little easier. And we'll do this twice. Just like that. And of course, this is where you use the lighter to heat this material to make it shrink up around the housing. See how that there shrinks right up? You just keep moving around. Don't let it get too hot all at once. You can melt it. But just keep moving around. All those wrinkles will mostly disappear. Well, that's pretty good right there. So now you repeat. And you can use the soapy water, it doesn't hurt anything. That's with both of them on there. Next, you're going to want to be able to put a zip tie through this housing right here. And that's where we're going to use that drill. This is where I take a 1/3 drill bit and put a hole right through the top of the housing, all the way through. This is for one of the zip ties to connect to your chainstay. Pretty simple. You just drill it up. You want to use a vise so it doesn't slip or so you don't hurt yourself. Now you have everything you need to attach this to the bicycle. Pretty easy. I'll take you over and show you how I have mine on. Take a good look at it. If you can't figure that out, I can't help you. See ya. And this is a pretty close look of how it is. Pretty simple to do. As you can see, spins freely. Very, very minimal, if any, wear inside there. There's a divot, but that's actually not a wear through it. I've put about 30 miles on that one there. And even if it does wear through in a year, who cares? Those reflectors cost hardly anything. Ride and be safe.